What up, what up, what up, fellow agents? Pure Prime here, back again with another build, guys. And yes, this build hits up to 20 million a crit shot. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content and watching it. Appreciate it a lot. And today I'm gonna show you a build for the Mantis. Of course, we know we can unlock the Mantis after level 55 in the season, the non-paid track, so you don't have to pay for the Mantis to drop at level 55. You only have to, of course, have the expansion Warlord of New York. But guys, this build hits so freaking hard. You combine it with two talents. One old talent, the Vigilance on the backpack, and one extremely nice new talent, giving up to 1250% weapon damage. Yes, guys, that's why this is hitting for almost 20 million, or a little over 20 million a shot when I crit. And I built a little crit build, so as you see on the gameplay, I do a lot of crit shots and this does a lot of damage. You're almost always doing 15, 16 million damage, guys. And then with your skills, throwing your decoy out and then resetting when you only do another headshot with your Mantis. Man, this combination rocks. Up to 20 million a headshot. Man, this is so much fun. I didn't realize that I could have so much fun with the marksman rifle. You know that Nemesis with this build as well hits very hard. With this build around 55, 58 million, but you need to charge it, you know. If you are alone, you charging all the time, you will get flanked. So I'm loving the Mantis up until now. So yeah, guys, I think that is enough gameplay for now. Let me show you what I made. Yes, guys, this is the build, and as you can see, I'm rocking a 3 pieces of Aces, 1 piece of the new Walker Harrison Co., a piece of Araldi, and 1 piece Overlord. And Overlord, of course, to boost my M1A a little bit and giving me that 8% damage to target out of cover. But let's start with my Aces. And why the 3 pieces? 15% marksman rifle damage and 30% headshot damage. Not the 4 pieces, because I wanted to build a crit build around this Mantis. And yes, you can hit extremely hard with the 4 pieces as well, but I went for a crit chance. I rolled crit chance on here, 15% weapon damage already on there, and 11.4% critical hit damage mod. Then over to my gloves, again 6% critical hit chance and a max cap of 15% weapon damage. And then of course for my holster, exactly the same, I rolled that 6% critical hit chance on there. I couldn't craft a higher than 12.6%, I couldn't find a higher than 12.6%, so this is pretty decent, but the whole build isn't at its max, guys. You can still build and you can hit harder than that 20 million I'm hitting for with that Mantis. Then over to my god roll of this build. Look at this, guys. 15% weapon damage. I rolled 6% critical hit chance, 12% critical hit damage, and 11.4% critical hit damage mod on there. Why the Walker and Harris? Because this comes with perfect headhunter, and that 5% weapon damage is also nice. And the perfect headhunter, guys, what will that do for us? After killing an enemy with a headshot, your next weapon hit within 30 seconds deals an additional 150% of that killing blow's damage. The damage is kept to 800% of your weapon damage. This is raised to 1250% if your headshot damage is greater than 150%. And luckily for us, we have higher than 150%, so our max damage is kept to that 1250%, and that's why we can reach up to that 20 million a shot. Then over to my backpack, Araldi. Why Araldi? Of course, that marksman rifle damage bonus. This could be way better, guys. I only have 10% weapon damage on my backpack, 10.7% critical hit damage, 4.6% critical hit chance, and a mod of 11.3% critical hit damage. And then, of course, vigilance on there. Increased total weapon damage by 25%. Taking damage disables this buff for 4 seconds. We are working with the Mantis, we're working from a distance, and we're working, of course, with our decoy. So you're not getting hit that often. So that 25% extra boost for your weapon damage is very, very nice to get up to that 20 million. And then Overlord. Why Overlord? Of course, that damage you target out of cover, and just like I explained, the 10% rifle damage for my M1A, if I wanna switch over, if my skills are not up to the task, if they're coming close, I would love to shoot with my M1A and still do a lot of damage with it. 15% weapon damage, 8% damage to target out of cover, and I rolled 12% critical hit damage on there. I could go for a critical hit chance to get my critical hit chance up enough. Just like you saw in the gameplay, I shoot a lot of crit shots. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much the build. And let's head over to the M1A. Hitting for 482k. I rolled 15% rifle damage on there. It already got 14% critical hit chance, 8% damage to target out of cover, and rifleman. We are shooting at the head, so you want that rifleman on there, in my opinion. Landing a headshot adds a stack of 10% weapon damage for 5 seconds. Max stack of 5, additional headshot refresh to duration. So if you want to switch over or need to switch over to your M1A, this is a very nice talent to have because you want to shoot that headshots because we are rocking that perfect headhunter. Over to the Mantis, guys. It's all about this gun, guys. 846k damage, an RPM of 60. That's pretty decent for a sniper rifle, in my opinion, and a mag of 7. I rolled it to 15% marksman rifle, 101 headshot damage, and 9% damage to target out of cover. And then the talent, guys, in plain sight. Your scoped view displays additional information about enemies not targeting you. Just like you saw in the gameplay, those red circles around their heads, you know, weak points, we need to shoot some headshots. Headshots and weak points against enemies not targeting you are amplified by 50%. So this is a very, very nice boost. So if you're not taking damage or not taking aggro at all, they are focused on your decoy, then you can do a lot of damage. Headshot kills reset cooldown of the decoy skill. This bonus will wait until the decoy goes into cooldown if currently active. So this means it doesn't work until your decoy is in cooldown. So if your decoy is in cooldown, shoot a headshot and it will come back again. It's not waiting until it goes on cooldown and then jumps back again because you did a headshot some 4 or 5 kills ago. No, you need to shoot a headshot while it is in cooldown. But it's pretty easy with this build. And yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. The handgun, yeah, I'm not using it. Of course, the sniper specialization for that headshot damage extra, and of course that stability, you can rock a little bit better with a rifle and of course with the Mantis if you are going for that sniper rifle. And then of course my skills, guys, I chose for the revive hive because yeah, this is mainly a solo build, or yeah, of course you can use it in a team. Everybody is aggroing everybody, so you can sit in the back just quietly sniping everybody. That could be nice, but for me, I chose for the revive hive. And then, of course, for the decoy. Why the decoy? Because it refreshes with the headshots, of course, with our exotic sniper rifle, the Mantis. And you don't want that aggro because then your damage is multiplied by 50%. And that is a lot, guys. And yeah, this has a cooldown of 22.7 seconds. Doesn't really matter if you do a headshot. A duration of 18.1 seconds. And it has a health of almost 1 million. So that is what I'm rocking for my skills, guys. And then let's head over to the stats. First stats, of course, let's head over to the Mantis because this is the main gun that we are using. Hitting for 846k weapon damage, a critical hit chance of 43.6%, a critical hit damage of 113.8%, and a headshot damage of 186%, guys. And now our weapon damage is kept to that 1250% because we are above 150%. I tried it out to raise the critical hit damage a little bit and lower the headshot damage, but yeah, it's almost the same damage. So you can stack into headshot damage or stack into critical hit damage. It's almost the same, whatever you like to stack into. Then over to the next one, guys. Offensive, 94.6% all weapon damage bonus, but then another 55% marksman rifle damage bonus. So this gives us combined a 149.6% all weapon damage bonus. Because, yeah, the Mantis is the main gun we are using. And if we are switching over to that M1A, we're getting a 119.4% all weapon damage bonus. And then, of course, combined with that headshot damage, critical hit chance, and critical hit damage, man, just like you saw, this is hitting so freaking hard. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. I, of course, stacked into the red core, so the rest isn't that interesting in my opinion. And of course, the rest is coming from my watch. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the build, guys. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.